have Vishu Surana with us. Hi Vishu, how are you?
Yes, I'm good, how are you?
Vishu, prepared with Career Launcher under the program LST for admission into the National Law Schools. She has scored third highest marks in IELTS 2017, held for admission in NLU Delhi. And let me first congratulate her again for performing so well. And today we'll share certain thoughts that Vishu has in her mind to help students prepare well for these entrance examinations. And I hope these tips will help you all. Thank you. So Vishu, my first question to you is, how did you prepare for the law entrance examinations?
Okay, so my strategy was initially finding out all my weaknesses and my strengths. So what I did was, in the beginning of class 12, I gave a lot of mocks. So I did not score that well because I wasn't prepared, obviously. But what I found out was what is tested, what I'm supposed to prepare, what is expected. And then I looked section by section at all the 5 sections. I found out like I'm good at maths or I'm weak at GK. So I did that. So that helped me realize how to prepare and what to prepare. After that, I made daily plans. So what I did was I took one topic, let's say from maths, and I thoroughly read the concept from wherever I could find. Then in that day itself, I found out all the questions related to that topic so that I could practice it in one day and thoroughly clear the concept so that I don't have to come back to that again.
Right.
So I did that till September, October. When I was thorough with all my maths concepts, all the legal reasoning concepts, all the logical reasoning concepts, I focused more on giving mocks. Because now I was prepared, I knew a lot of concepts, I was clear. I knew that now I should test my preparation and find out what I'm scoring. So there was a significant improvement in my score because I had so much already prepared. After that, because all my concepts were clear, I started focusing more on GK from September onwards. I thoroughly read newspapers. Even though there was not so much information in the newspaper, I had a general idea of what is expected and what is going around in the world. So then I went to a lot of online sites, I went through CL's material, I did all the static knowledge, general knowledge I could find. I did not mug them up because I am not that kind of person. So I just went through them repetitively so that it stuck.
Right.
Okay, so then till January I did that, then obviously I had my 12 goals, I had to focus on that. But April onwards, I gave as many mocks as I could. I brushed up all my concepts again and I focused a lot on GK. And there, as you can see, there were a lot of questions on GK from the past few months.
Right.
So that helped. So I think for every student, I think it's very important to first find out what your strengths and weaknesses are. You should know which subject or section you're good at. You should practice on that and make it stronger. But more importantly, you have to develop your weaknesses more. You have to overcome those weaknesses. Don't be afraid of any subject. It's not possible to be good at everything from the very beginning. But if you practice, I'm sure you'll manage.
Great, great, great. So I hope everybody's understood that Vishu's strategy was very clear about what she had to do. She first understood what are her strong areas and what are her weak areas. She gave the mocks initially to understand which areas is she supposed to focus on and which are strong. Then she prepared every concept properly, and by doing a given concept, she did it from whatever material she had available. She did questions on that given concept only. And this is how she prepared every concept properly. Once her preparation was over, you again wrote the marks, right? And then you understood and realized that your performance improved significantly, and that instilled a confidence in you, and today the result is there. Great. Thank you.
Okay. So, Vishu, tell me what was the strategy on the day of the exam? How did it improve?
So, this is very important, right? Because it all comes down to that day. So, I think it's very important to be calm. You should be confident that what you've prepared is enough. You don't need to stress that day that, oh, I forgot this concept, oh, my friends have done so much, because you'll only end up confusing and feeling demoralized. So what I did was, one day before the exam, I completely stopped studying. I only watched movies, I went out with my family. I just went to my GK notes, because that's the only thing you can do last minute, right? I did not give any mock the last day because I knew that I had to be fresh and calm and composed. So on the day of the IELTS paper, I was feeling pretty confident, right? Even though I knew I was not 100% prepared, I could have done much more, but I was confident because I feel that's most important. If you think that, you know, oh, maine ye nahi kiya and all that, even if something is there in the paper which you know, you might end up missing out or you might make mistakes or something. So when you get the paper, because IELTS is a pen paper test, I think it's very important that you go through the paper for 2 minutes. You might think that it's going to end up wasting a lot of time, 2 minutes is a lot, I can do 5 questions. But no, I think you need to have a clear idea of what is there in the question.
Right.
Because again, as you saw this year's paper, there were a lot of unexpected things. There was no RC, legal reasoning questions were
right.
So long. So I had a clear strategy in my mind that I'm going to start with legal reasoning. But once I saw the paper, I saw the question was so long, I decided not to start with it.
You changed your strategy.
I changed my strategy that very minute.
Right.
I took a minute to think of my new strategy.
Right.
I did not waste a lot of time.
Right.
But I knew that because I spent a minute there, I could save a lot of time in the next hour and a half. So I think it's very important to do that. Also, there's a scenario that it might be a difficult paper, right?
Right.
Maybe for you, but if it's difficult, it's difficult for everyone. You need to remember that.
Right.
In my class itself, there were a lot of people who just gave up. They were so scared of the paper. They felt that they had not prepared enough.
Right.
They were just sitting for 30 minutes doing
nothing,
which is not a good idea, right? Even if you don't know, at least try. Don't think about the result. I mean, at that time you shouldn't think, oh, kaash maine ye kar liya hota, what will my parents say, what if I don't
so
get
it? So you kept
it?
On trying?
I kept on trying. There were some stuff which I did not know, but I still gave my best shot. And obviously, I could guess even if I didn't know something, because there's no negative marking
right.
in IELTS at least.
Right.
So at that minute, just don't lose your mental calm. Give your best, and then obviously.
So what I can make out from this is, so you need to have a strategy in mind, but be flexible.
But
that is what you said.
Exactly.
You know, that is one important thing. And second important thing is persistent. So she was persistent, trying to attempt problems till the last minute, wherein your friends gave it up half an hour before the exam because it was a difficult paper. So well done, Vishu. Great. Okay. I remember the time 2 years back when Vishu came to us along with her father, mother and sister. I was the one who counseled her, mentored her, and today here I am, congratulating her, facilitating her with the results. So it makes me feel very good. Okay, Vishu, one very important question which I want to understand from you is, how did CL help? How will you say the role of career launcher, LST in the preparation over a period of 2 long years?
Right. So at this time, CL has a monopoly in the law entrance field, right?
Okay.
Their material is extensive. If you look at their general knowledge books and all the concepts, it's so clear. Even if you just go through it, even
right.
if you're not in a classroom program, even if you just have the material, it's really easy to understand because it's really, really clear and easy to understand. Again, the mocks, I think they're of really, really good quality because the mocks helped me a lot, right? That's how I understood what can be expected in the paper, how well prepared I am.
Right.
That is very important. The LST site, the portal is amazing. It's so easy to access. It's very user friendly.
Right.
You have so many sectional tests and daily tests. That helped me a lot.
Test gym is there. Yes.
The GK daily news,
GK
all that.
News.
That is very helpful because it adds to
right.
my material,
right?
So,
right.
It
helps.
Okay.
So today we have Vishu and Vishu's mother with us. I would want to understand from both of you, how was the atmosphere at home? What is it that you did, ma'am, to ensure that she's stress-free? And how did you share your things with mom and dad and others in the family? Your grandparents were also there with you. So how did you all ensure that at home there was a lot of support for her?
So I have a very friendly family. There was no stress, no pressure from their side. I could talk to them about anything. There were times when I felt demotivated. I wasn't sure. There was no improvement in my scores. I always used to go talk to mom and dad. What is happening? Nothing is happening. Will I get in? Kya hoga and all.
Mm-hmm.
They always comforted me. They were like, don't think about all that. Don't think about the results. Just give your best for preparing.
Right.
So they were like my friends, I could talk to them about anything.
I mean, we always said, just
do your work. Don't
right.
worry about the results.
Right.
If you'll work, God will always repay your results.
Absolutely.
So, and we never pressurized her since it was 12th also for her. We never pressurized her for the boards.
Hmm.
We said, what's your priority? You decide that and work on that.
So you all were also clear that the priority is
the
law entrance examinations,
yeah.
and then boards are at the back seat.
Exactly.
Very nice, very nice. And I think you all had discussions also at home.
Yeah, at night
you were sharing
husband,
with me.
Yeah, night every 10-15 minutes daily we used to have a small discussion, family discussion. How
right.
was the day? Yeah, did you read the newspaper? This is the news which can help you in the paper.
Oh,
my
great.
Husband was always, because he's an avid reader, so he
right.
always used to say, did you read this news? This might come. In fact, the day before the exam also, that China,
he told me a lot, 2-3 questions which did
which
come.
Really did
okay.
come in the paper.
Very nice.
So he said, Vishu, did you read about this? This might come. So yeah, day before she read just that news, and it really came in the paper.
Right.
So it was like this, he used to have a healthy quality discussion rather than not just like that.
And more importantly, like during exams, I've seen a lot in my friends' families and all, there's a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm.
No one talks to anyone.
Yes,
oh,
yes.
They're only talking about how have you prepared, how are you going to do and all
right,
that.
Right.
At my house, it's complete opposite.
Right.
I don't study a day before the exam, and we have like a rule that just the previous day you have to go out.
Hmm.
And so I had to go for shopping or a movie. So I'm like, really
just simply go and have an ice cream.
Right, right.
Yeah, it was like that.
Right.
My
so everybody ensured that there was a very
cool
atmosphere at home,
right.
so that she could focus on her studies, and you supported her. I'm surprised to know that you and
yeah,
sir used to sit with her.
I never
asked
her, did you do this? Did you study? Because I knew ki she's big enough to take care of that.
Right.
She needs our mental support right now. Rather than I asking her, did you study this? Did you study that? Because I knew she'll do that part.
Right.
She needs our support.
Absolutely.
Right now. Yeah, we are with you. Whatever way you want our help, I'm there for you.
I think it's a great advice for the parents. The way Vishu's parents held her, I think that support, if given to any student, it can help them a lot in achieving what they want to. Thank you. Thank you for your time.